buddy Little Joe from Back Bay Scale Customs and the band Knuckle Deep again. The Lincoln One, guys, here it is. I'm going to be building it for y'all. I don't have any idea what kind of color I want to put it, but I've been trying to put a video up with you guys, but, you know, I'll tell you what. Let me just show y'all what I've been working with.
Stop! Lindsay, shut up! Lindsay, stop!
Oh, well, you know, it is what it is. All right, guys. I got this kid here, and I'll be showing y'all that. Rick Carter did a review on the kit itself, but here's a kit from 1979 that I picked up. Really cool. I'm gonna be building this on the channel too. But this kit's really, really old. Got some pictures of that. But here's the stuff for this car. The plastic's really brittle, and some of the stuff's falling off the sprues. The body has some cracks in it. It's just, I'm just going to have to take my time with it, guys, and do it right for y'all. But y'all give me some suggestions. Let me know what kind of color y'all want it, and let me know, or some suggestions of what color I might want to paint it that y'all would like. But, okay, that's pretty much it. Now, back to Tom for the weather. All right, guys, there's a slideshow coming up with the Randy Mandy project. It's finished, and the Tim Richmond project, the chassis on it's done. Decals fell to pieces on me. I've got to get two sets of those decals. Slicks does not carry NASCAR decals anymore, and it's getting hard to find them. So if you guys know anybody that has Slicks or has NASCAR decals that I can get my hands on, I need two sets of Tim Richmond decals. For the 1986-87 Red Folgers Monte Carlo, if y'all have any idea of where to get that. But all right, here's the Randy Mandy project and the Tim Richmond project and some more pictures of some other things. So we'll see you later.